Weekly bars quality control for spatial resolution and linearity. Begin by initiating extrinsic both pre-programmed motion. Ensure that the pre-programmed motion is complete. Use the mobile shield, place it near the detectors. Again, with the extrinsic test, it will not affect the acquisition. Bring the 4-quadrant bar phantom. This phantom is relatively heavy. Be very careful not to insert it edge first and damage any collimator surfaces. Center the 4-quadrant bar phantom in the middle of the field of view. Obtain the planar sheet source. And we have an option of using either a sealed cobalt sheet source or fillable phantom sheet source. If you are using the fillable sheet source, we would need to place a blue pad on top of the 4-quadrant bar phantom before covering it with the sheet source. Another blue pad would have to be placed on top of the sheet source so the detector above the source can be lowered and contacted with the source. Allow for little contact without triggering the collision alert. Enter the QA calibration menu from the main screen of the Jetstream acquisition program. Entering the study data. Study name, capitals. XX space QC space bars. Study ID, date, and your initials. After pressing proceed, select the bars quality control procedure. Confirm the appropriate settings. Here we have detector 1 set up as an extrinsic flood since it does not have a bar phantom placed against it. detector 2 is set up for the bars acquisition. We see a difference in counts. Extrinsic flood is set up for 18 million and the bars acquisition is set up for 5 million counts. We selected cobalt 57 as the isotope here since we are using the cobalt sheet source. Select technetium if you are using the fillable phantom sheet source. Daily quality control would be performed prior to this procedure, as it is a weekly QC procedure. If we chose to do an extrinsic flood on detector 1, we would peak it. Detector 2, having the bars acquisition, would have been peaked previously. Note the decreased count rate on the detector with the bar phantom on, due to the attenuation of the lead bars. Start the acquisition. Note the progress slider and ensure that the acquisition is in progress. Verify the proper placement of the bar phantom on the detector. If the bar phantom is not centered, correct the position and restart the acquisition. After the acquisition is complete, move the detectors apart and remove the source first. In order for the weekly bars procedure to be complete, 4 images have to be taken per detector. The bar phantom has to be rotated by 90 degrees. The source replaced and another acquisition completed. After that, the bar phantom would have to be flipped and another acquisition completed. And finally, another rotation by 90 degrees. For the purpose of the lab competency skill evaluation, we will perform only one view and the rest of the procedure will be explained by the student. Use additional care when removing the bar phantom from in between the detectors. Lift off the detector surface as not to scratch or cause any other damage. Here is a quick review of the positions that would be required for each detector. So it's a total of 8 images for the weekly spatial resolution linearity. The analysis for this test is done qualitatively only. Enter the QC tools from the analysis menu. Select detector 1. Display the image. Identify the quadrants and a degree of visualization of the bars. And repeat the same for detector 2. These images would be compared to previous and saved on a disk on a weekly basis.